Morning and Jai Hind students, I am Kanchan, your English teacher. This time I have taken the summary of the chapter The Address by Malga Minko. Characters are here, the author Mrs. Darling and author's mother Mrs. Darling's daughter. So author is Malga Minko herself and Mrs. Darling is an acquaintance of her mother and author's mother is Mrs. S. and Mrs. Darling's daughter. So this story is a very touching story and this story is about pre-war and post-war. So this story also tells us how war affects the lives of civilians as well. It disturbs the normal life and leads to conflicts and tension. So in this story, Holland was fighting for independence. The narrator had joined the forces. It was a long drawn and deadly war. Success was seeming impossible, but anyhow they got their success. They became free, and then author had only her mother, Mrs. S, at home, and she was worried about the safety of her costly belongings. She had a lot of silver cutlery and antiques. One day, an old acquaintance, Mrs. Darling, came to her house and she made contact with author's mother और उन्होंने पूरा assure किया कि मैं आपकी चीजों को संभाल कर रखूंगी. उसके बाद author की mother ने सारी चीजें उनको दे दी and she had given all her valuable things including silver cutlery and antique plates, crockery, vase, everything she had given, even clothes also. So every time Mrs. Darling would come and take away all the things with her. So once author was there on holidays at home, then she found the things missed. Then she asked about those things from her mother, and her mother just scolded her. And then author was feared at that time. She could not tell about those things next time. But her mother told one address, Marconi Street, house number 46. And once when she was at home, then she met with Mrs. Darling. Mrs. Darling was a heavy lady having a broad back. Then gradually everything became more normal again. And after the independence, when Holland got independence, author also came to her house, but her mother was no more. She had lost all interest in the things handed over to Mrs. Darling. After all, those things used to be kept in boxes and cupboards, they were rarely. But one day she thought to remember those things. She thought to go to Mrs. Darling's house because her mother told her address of Mrs. Darling. To see those things, to touch those things as the memories of her mother. So when she went to Marconi Street, house number 46, a woman opened the door partly, means not completely, and she did not identify. इसका मतलब है कि Mrs. Darling ने उसको पहचाना ही नहीं. She had not expected the girl to come back home alive. She refused to recognize the author and narrator for a while wondered if she had come to a wrong place. But when she read the name plate, she was sure that she was at the correct address. Mrs. Darling did not recognize her and she saw the name plate again and she found she was at the correct address. But Mrs. Darling was a greedy lady. She did not recognize the author. Then second time she decided to try. Then she visited Mrs. Darling's house second time, and second time Mrs. Darling's 15-year-old daughter opened the door. Mrs. Darling was not at home. The narrator decided to wait. She followed the girl along the passage. She saw her heavy candle holders. She saw her own candle holder next to a mirror. She was taken to a living room. She found herself in the midst of things. उसने अपनी चीजों को पहचाना. She felt painful because all the things that were of her mother's belongings were kept in a very tasteless way, in a very ugly way. So damp smelling was there, furniture was ugly, and she sat down at a table and noticed the tablecloth was hers. It had a burn mark and it was not repaired. So the girl said that her mother would be come back soon, and she offered tea for her. The narrator recognized all the things. She found that all the things were kept in a very tasteless way to which she would use. जिस जिन चीज़ों को वो यूज़ करती थी वही चीज़ें बहुत ही गलत ढंग से रखी हुई थी. देन मिसेज डार्लिंग्स डॉटर ऑल्सो नोटिस दैट द कटलरी शी यूज एवरी डे वॉज सिल्वर. शी ओपेंड अ ड्रॉर टू ब्रिंग आउट मोर स्पून्स एंड फॉक्स बट द नरेटर डिड नॉट वेट टू सी दिम एंड द नरेटर डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू रिटर्न सेकेंड नेक्स्ट टाइम एंड शी डिसाइडेड दैट शी विल फॉरगेट द एड्रेस बिकॉज she knew very well that she will not be able to get those things back because Mrs. Darling was not an honest lady. So at the corner of the road, she again read the nameplate. The address was correct, but she didn't want to remember it anymore. She had no intention to visit that house again because she felt painful, and moreover, she had no need of them in her small rented room. Only a handful of cutlery fitted in the narrow table drawer. So she made up her mind to forget that address. उसने सोच लिया कि मैं इस एड्रेस को भूल जाऊंगी and then she would feel comfortable and relaxed. So this is the story of this chapter, the address that moves around the address. Thank you and Jai Hind.